Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. Today, I'm going to be doing something that I've actually never done on my channel. Today, I'm going to be editing a photo. So I'm actually just gonna take you through kind of my general editing process and the steps that I take while I'm editing a photo. I wanna let you guys know that this is not necessarily a how-to video, this is really just my own personal process and how I go about editing a photo. With that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and jump into this edit. All right, guys, let's go ahead and get started on this edit. So the first thing I'm gonna do before I actually even touch anything over here as far as editing is I wanna decide what the mood is and what I wanna portray in this image. My general philosophy when editing photos is I don't want to change an image. I want to enhance what's already going on in the image. So, you know, I want to kind of give you an idea of what I saw when I was there, standing there in person with my own eyes. A lot of times the camera just doesn't necessarily do it justice. So you have to use editing techniques to kind of pull that out of an image. So when I'm looking at this image and just kind of thinking back on where I was in Canada. It was really snowy, really cold that day. And also it was the middle of the day too. So I really wanna show kind of the white in the snow, the blue in the sky. I wanna enhance the clouds and kind of show the grandness and the scale of the image. And I really like this light that's coming in. So you can see this light kind of coming in here in the middle of the image. I want to kind of enhance that so that that pops out a little bit more as well too. So those are the kind of things I'm going to focus on while I'm editing this image. The first thing I want to do is go down here to my lens corrections tab and I want to enable profile corrections. So the reason I'm doing this is every lens has lens distortion, especially ultra wide lenses. They have a lot of lens distortion. So this was shot on my Canon EF 17-40. So that is an ultra wide lens. So there's a lot of distortion around the edges. So when I enable these profile corrections, it corrects the distortion around the edges of the image. And so you can see when I click it, it's sharp, it straightens out the edges of the photo there. It also kind of brightens the edges. Like there's a little bit of a vignetting before and after. So the last thing you want to do is edit an image and then click on this and have it change the image. So you want to do this first. It's just as simple as clicking this button here and your lens should come up. Lightroom is pretty smart. It's pretty intuitive and it recognizes most lenses right away. I don't know how it does that, but it does it. So if it doesn't, you can click here and you can select the lens that you used. And it actually even has like options for the iPhone as well. But we don't want to go there. We want to click on ours. So you can always pretty much, if you have any type of lens, it's in here and it'll correct for it. So once that's done, we're going to go up here. We're going to size our image. This image was shot portrait style. So when I say portrait, I mean the long way because I shot with the intent of posting this on Instagram. So you can see I shot some landscape here. And that looks really cool. But I shot some portrait as well because these just fit better on an iPhone screen, so they fit better on Instagram. So I will crop for that. So this is where I generally do my cropping. So I'm gonna size it for Instagram. So when I click here, it's gonna give me a bunch of options for sizing my photo. I'm gonna click on this 4x5, 8x10. This is the proper size for Instagram. It fits right into your feed. So I'll go ahead and click that. And then we'll just kind of figure out where I want this image to lay. I really like the sky here. I like the clouds. I don't want the mountain to be dead in the middle because that's just kind of obvious. I want it to be off a little bit. So kind of a rule of thirds type of thing. So I have the mountains kind of, they're here in the middle, but they're kind of leaning towards the top of the image. And then I get a lot of sky still here in the image. So I'm happy with that. So I'll click on that. This image looks pretty straight. So if you want to check to make sure it's straight, you can always go down here to transform and you can click auto and it will auto adjust your image. This one, it looks like it pulled it forward a little bit on the side. I'm not a huge fan of that, so I'm just gonna leave it. This is usually pretty smart, but sometimes it does some wacky stuff to images, so I'm just gonna leave it off. It looks pretty straight to me, so I'm happy with where it's at. So now we'll get into just kind of the global editing aspect of it.
typically I like my images warmer. This is the first option here, is the temperature option. So you can have a, you can cool your image down or warm it up here. I tend to have warmer images. I don't want to get too crazy with this because I like the blue in the sky and I don't want to lose that blue. So see, as you get warmer, you start to lose the blue in the sky and you get some weird colors in your trees. I want to warm this image up, especially because of the snow. I don't want blue in my snow. I want that snow to be really white. So I'm going to warm it up here a little bit. Probably like right there. That looks good to me. Next thing I'll do is I'll move down here to the exposure. It looks like I shot it pretty well. I'm pretty happy with the exposure right now. Obviously you can see there's a bit of a dark kind of area down here, a dark shadow at the bottom of the image, and there's not a lot of light in these trees and on these trees, so I will give it a little bit of a boost, but not going to go crazy with the exposure, because when you raise your exposure you start to lose a lot of details, and you can see the higher you go, the more detail you start to lose in your image. So you don't want to get too crazy with this exposure here. I'm going to raise it a little bit, but there's other ways that I can get rid of these shadows that I'll show you here pretty soon. So the next tab is the contrast. So this is just creating contrast between the different colors and the different objects in your image. So I like to enhance the contrast a little bit, just to help my trees kind of, these trees are kind of blurred together, so I can help them kind of pop out and stand out a little bit. It helps my clouds a little bit as well. So I'll add a little bit of contrast there. Next is a really important tab, especially when you're dealing with clouds in your sky, and that is the highlights. So the highlights are the brightest part of your image. And these are obviously the brightest part of our image. The clouds and the snow and stuff are the brightest parts. So you can turn the highlights down, so kind of darken the brightest parts of your image, which helps these clouds stand out in the sky. So you get more detail in your clouds when you drop the highlights like this. So I'll go ahead and drop it. I'll drop it all the way down. Some images you can't, you have to be careful with this. Things get kind of wacky if you drop your highlights all the way down. So, but this image, like a midday shot like this, it's totally fine to drop your highlights like that, and it helps, like as you can see, I'll do it again, it really helps bring out the detail in those clouds. So I'm gonna drop my highlights there. Now we're moving on to shadows. Now we'll be able to get more kind of light down here at the bottom of the image, and then get some light in between these trees here with the shadow. So I will raise the shadows there, and as you can see, starting to brighten up the rest of the image there. So very cool. So now we're moving down to the whites and the blacks. So this is another area where you can create contrast within the image. So I typically like to drop the blacks down and turn the whites up, and that's just another way to create contrast in the image. As you can see, things are starting to pop out a little bit more, starting to stand out. So that's a pretty cool look. I definitely want to raise the whites as well, because I want this white that's in the snow to pop out and really stand out. So let me raise the shadows a little bit more. So you have to be careful with these shadows as well, especially depending on your lens and your sensor on your camera. If you raise your shadows too much, you have, you know, if your ISO is really high, or if you don't have the best sensor on your camera, you can start to get a lot of noise and a lot of fringing around the edges of your image when you raise your shadows. So be careful with the shadows. Be sure to pay attention to the details and make sure you're not getting a bunch of noise and crazy stuff. It looks pretty sharp down here in the corner, so I'm comfortable with that. All right, so moving on to the presence area. This, I typically don't do a lot here because a lot goes a long way with all three of these tabs here. This is clarity, vibrance, and saturation. So clarity, it'll add kind of just an extra pop, like it adds clarity. So it adds more detail into all the aspects of the image. But as you start, as you can see, you go down and it makes it kind of glossy, like weird, dreamy kind of looking. So this, a little goes a long way with this stuff. If you add too much, it starts to get kind of crazy, kind of HDR fake kind of looking. So you don't want to add too much clarity. I'll add a little bit just to help kind of things pop a little bit. So I'll add like 5 vibrance. I just typically don't touch the vibrance. To me, it just makes things look fake. You add it there and it gets wild really quickly, so I typically don't even touch that stuff. I like kind of the natural colors that are here in the image. I don't want to add any crazy kind of anything to it, so I will stick with no. Let me go back to zero. It's hard to get back to zero. you ever have a hard time like that getting to zero, you can just click there, click zero, hit enter, and it'll stick at zero. So saturation, I do want to add a little bit of saturation to help the colors pop here, but again, just a little, a lot goes a long way with this stuff, and you start to get these weird kind of fake looking colors. So I will add just a little bit of saturation, add a little 10 there, maybe a little bit more. And there we go, cool. So this next tab here is the tone curve. So this tone curve represents all the tones within the image. So these are your darkest tones down here, and these are your brightest tones. And then this is the midpoint here, and these would be your shadows and highlights. So you can control each aspect of your photo through this tone curve. So what I typically like to do is create 3 points here on this tone curve. So make sure when you're down here, you clicked on this tab where you can use these points to create different points on your tone curve. So the first area I want to click on is right here in the middle. So this is the midpoint. Down here represents the shadows. So I'll click a point here, and then the highlights are up here. So I'll click those 3 points. And the reason I click those points is because I can now control these. So these are the highlights up here. So now I can control the highlights here, and you can see I can make the image a lot brighter or a lot darker there. And then the shadows down here, you can do the same. So you can control these aspects of the image like that. And then this is these are the midpoints here, and you can do the same. So it's really just breaking down the image into 3 different parts, and then you can control it from there. So typically I like to do kind of a slight S curve. Like, honestly, it really isn't much. So I'll drop my highlights to kind of get, again, some more detail out of my clouds. So I'll drop it a little bit there. And then I'll raise my shadows just to get a little bit more light in the shadows there. And then boom. So nothing crazy there. That's a little bit of tweaking to the image. And so what I personally like to do is I like to add a little fade to my images. And so a lot of people, typically they say, I get this comment a lot on Instagram, where people say like, oh, like I can notice your images right away because they all have kind of a similar look to it. And typically that's because I do what I do here in the tone curve. I do this for every photo, and so I keep a consistent look to my photos. So what I like to do is add fade. So I'll create another point here, which will help me add some fade to this. So I'll create a point right here, and I'll drag the end up there, and voila, I just add a little bit of fade. I'll move that. So I added some fade into the image, which gives it kind of my unique look, I guess. I mean, it's not anything crazy, but it is, you know, it's what I like in my images, and it kind of gives a uniform look to all of my stuff. So if I want to add more fade, I can always pull the back end there as well. But I think I'm pretty happy with where it's at now. So yeah, it's kind of a wacky looking curve now, but this is typically where I kind of live at. So I'm happy with that. So I'll move down onto this is pretty much the area where you control your colors. So you can control the hue, saturation, and luminance of all the colors in your image. I'm pretty happy with what I have right now, but I could use a little bit more pop to the blue in the sky there. So I might want to add a little bit of that, but again, I don't want the blue to go crazy in my snow as well. So I'll see what happens when I add a little bit of blue. So you can add saturation to the blue to get a little bit more pop in the sky, but you can see it's starting to kind of creep into the snow there. So I won't get too crazy with that. And then if I wanted to kind of bring some color out in these trees, I could add some green, some saturation to the green, and get a little bit more green out of those trees. There's not a lot of green in those to start with, but yeah, that helps a little bit. Helps some kind of colors stand out a little bit there. That's typically where I operate. I don't get too much into all this. It depends on the image. Like if I was doing something with kind of fall colors, I would work more here in the oranges and the oranges here. But I really want to stay kind of true to what I saw here. So just kind of, like I said, enhancing the sky a little bit because I like the sky, and enhancing the greens and the trees, but not changing anything. Split toning. Split toning is kind of the same thing. You can control the color and the tones in your image, and you can kind of give an overall feel to an image. And so this is I think it's for people who do kind of moodier edits. Mine are like I said, just kind of more true edits. So I typically don't do anything with split toning. I like to just keep it kind of as is. So I'll move down to the detail section. So this is where you can add like your sharpening and things, different things to you, the details of your images. You can add some sharpness to your image here, and then you can go into the masking and kind of determine where you want this to affect, where you want the sharpness to affect it. I typically don't dabble too much in that. It's pretty, my image is pretty sharp. I'm pretty happy with where it is. Wait for it to load. Yeah, that looks really good. So I don't need a whole lot of sharpening. It's kind of a nature photo, so it doesn't need a ton of that. Now the next tab down here is noise reduction. So this is usually for if you're shooting at night or if you're shooting for whatever reason with a high ISO and you want to get rid of some noise in your image. If you're noticing a bunch of noise, you can add noise reduction and it gets rid of that, but it really kind of softens the detail in your image. So you have to be careful with this stuff. It's hard to see from far away, but if you zoom in, you can see like it just kind of mushes all the details together to get rid of noise. So yeah, don't use too much noise reduction. So don't need any of that. Pretty happy with where I'm at now. So the image is looking cool so far. We'll go ahead and scroll on down to, we did all that. So we can do some post-crop vignetting. So we can add a little vignetting to the edges of the image. So you can add some kind of darkness to the edges. The idea with this is really, train coming by. I'm gonna cut this out hopefully. Sorry guys, light rail near me flying by. Sounds like it's gone. So the idea behind this is really that it kind of darkens the edges of the image where you kind of don't want the eye to be drawn. And so it draws the eye to the center of the image where you want people to see. I don't use a lot of vignetting. I might use a little bit, but sometimes it looks cool if you're going for like a moodier look. But I am not gonna do that. I don't wanna darken my snow. I want my snow to be bright, so I'm gonna leave that there. So this next tab is actually an interesting one. This is dehaze. I don't know a lot about dehaze. It gets rid of haze in your image. It's a really, really powerful tool though. So you can see if you use a lot of it, it gets really, really wild really quickly. So you got to be really light with this. But it does help bring out some detail in the clouds. So you can see I add more. Start to see some blue kind of popping out from the sky and some detail. Kind of this cloud start to pop out a little bit as well. So I use that sparingly, but I will use a little here because it doesn't hurt too much. And so down here is a camera calibration. So this is kind of another way to control your colors. So I typically like to add some kind of a little bit of turquoise, I guess, to my blues. So I usually like to do that. Not a lot here. I don't want to make it too crazy. So I'll add a little bit there and then I'll increase the saturation. So that's kind of cool there. See the sky start to pop a little bit more. And then I also sometimes I'll mess with the red primary depending on the image. That can be kind of cool to mess with. And then if I'm doing like a fall vibes kind of photo, this helps here with the greens to kind of turn the greens from this bright green down to like a kind of a fall color-y looking green there. So yeah, that's pretty much it. And so once I'm done with that, I'll kind of assess the image and I'll give it a look over. And I definitely want to get rid of the darkness down here and kind of make the snow pop out. So I'm gonna do some more tweaks. So I'll probably raise the exposure a little bit, try not to lose the color of my sky. And then I will raise the shadows probably all the way there to see if I can get a little bit more out of that. So that's looking better. I'm gonna add some more contrast here and I'll probably add a little bit more warmth to it. So now it's looking really, really good. I'm digging this. Looking sick. This is kind of looking how I was. It's kind of looking like it was when I was there. So now I like the way this is looking, but I want to really enhance this light that I'm seeing right here in the middle of the image. There was a bunch of clouds kind of covering the sun and some light was coming and it's just blasting this middle area right here. So I want to enhance that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over here to this radial filter. So what this does is it you can create a circle area within the image, and you can control the edit only within the circle. So it's pretty cool. So I created this circle, so I'm going to edit only this area within this circle. So this will help the light kind of that I see here pop out a little bit. So in order to get that look of like light kind of hitting this area, I'm gonna raise the exposure a little bit. So you can see the light is starting to increase there. I'm gonna raise the shadows a little bit. And I will warm it up as well. So there we go, it's looking pretty cool. It's harder to see when this is actually in the circles there. So if I click off, click enter, it'll go away. Enter again, and that's kind of cool. It's, you can see like the, actually I think I might need to give a little bit more love. Let's see here, I don't want to get too crazy. There we go, drop the highlights a little bit so we don't lose too much detail in that area. And there you go, it's kind of a cool little trick to just add that light, kind of enhance what was already there. Like I'm not really adding light there, I'm just enhancing the light that was already there live and in person. So that's pretty cool. I'm happy with where this image is right now. This is ready to go. Really quickly, I'll do a before and after so you guys can see the work that was done. So you can see it's really brighter, and we've made some colors really pop in this thing and brought some life to it, added a little bit of light. So I like it. I'm happy with where it is, and yeah. I would export it. I would probably, typically I shoot stuff over to Photoshop to do some kind of final tweaks there, but that's probably a whole nother video. So yeah, again, guys, thank you so much for tuning in. I really appreciate it. Hopefully this was helpful. Like I said, this isn't necessarily a how-to video. This is really just kind of an overview of my own personal process. So hopefully you can take something from that. And thank you for watching. Please feel free to subscribe, like this video, leave me some feedback. I really appreciate all of that. So thank you.